This is a quick tour of the backend of Squarespace. So Squarespace's tagline is build it beautiful, and they do have plenty of very, very beautiful designs to choose from, but their design ethos really transfers well to the administrative interface that you're gonna use to build your website, but that your website visitors won't actually see. So it's broken out in a fairly straightforward way. You know, pages is where you go to add, edit, and manage all the pages on your website. It comes with demo content that you can delete or duplicate, but actually edit the content of a page. You basically select it, and then you select each content block to edit the content, whether it's, you know, changing the actual content or changing the styling or deleting it. Each page comes with not only basic settings, such as choosing the URL slug, thumbnail image, but also plenty of advanced settings where you can change the header code injection. So this is basically where you can do A/B tests, retargeting, tracking, all that kind of thing. Back on design, Squarespace has a one-stop place where you can change the design, whether it's the template, logo, and all that. But you can also actually do custom CSS, which is unique among a lot of hosted design platforms. They have integrated Ecommerce, which has somewhat limited functionality for most of their plans, but is really interesting if you have, you know, one or two products that you just want to list and be able to accept payment for. They have plenty of other settings, places to add and edit your blog, marketing settings, and whatnot. One thing with Squarespace compared to Weebly is that they don't have a lot of help that's integrated into their platform, but they do have a lot of video walkthroughs and a developer section where you can actually go in and customize a lot of things. So that's what it looks like. You can see the full review with pros and cons at shiverweb.com. I have the link in the video description.